You know you're misbehaving now. You mustn't lose your mind. You're being so inelegant and frankly quite unkind. Excuse my indiscretion.
Anybody? Nobody. But it's about time somebody. Okay, so this is this show, Pins and Needles, that Harold Rome wrote for, like, the garment workers back in the 30s. I don't know the whole history, but it's all in here, and it's being re-released by Sony Masterworks. The point is, a young and stunning Barbara Streisand, her first recording, can you see? She was literally 19 years old. Harold Rome also wrote I Can Get It For Your Wholesale, which she was doing on Broadway, so I guess she got connected that way. Now, you know, Barbara's always, like, singing the old tunes in her concerts. Like, no one will remember this one. She never hauls out anything from this show. And I was obsessed with this in high school. I literally used to go to the, I think, Lido Beach or Long Beach Beach Club. By the way, it didn't belong. I would sneak in all the time, and I finally got caught in July. But the point is, I would sneak in all the time, and I had this on my little Walkman. We used to have Walkman in the old days. Anybody? Nobody. I have it on that. Listen to it all the time. So I will now deconstruct two songs. Okay. First one is, it's called, it's all about, like, unions. It's just, like, such a show, like, it's not Pajama Game. Anyway, it's all about unions. And Barbara's singing the song, it's not Cricket to Picket, which is obviously sung by, like, you know, a suit, as we say, who's busting people that are picketing. Hold on. All right. Anywho, so first of all, it degenerates. You'll see, like, each verse, she gets more and more frantic. So the first verse, she almost has, like, a sort of a British accent. She does her signature cough. I don't know, but Barbara always does this kind of thing where she goes, like, oh. Like, it's sort of a fake cough, but it's hilarious. She hauls that out very early on. She has her amazing French accent, which she hauled out from Je M'appelle Barbara. Anybody have that album where she sings? Anybody? Dans un sommeil que charme ton ima. Anybody remember that? I was obsessed with that. Classical Barbara, yet she's belting an opera song. Anywho, point is, she hauls out the French accent for comme il faut and for an entre nous. Amazing French accent. And then I love how she goes, exceedingly bad taste. She, like, just separates a bad taste. It's very bon, brun. Okay, here we go. Play.
It's not cricket to picket, not cricket. Oh no, it's just not comme il faut to picket. You haven't any right, you know. You're acting in great haste. Just think of the predicament in which your boss is placed. And entre nous, I think it's in exceedingly bad taste. Not cricket to picket, not cricket.
Okay, now she has her second, just not even a breakdown, but you just, she's sort of slowly slipping off the mask. She goes, atrocious and gauche, you know. Because what it is she's almost British, but then you really find out she's just like a Brooklyn Jew. She really is, like, that's sort of her character. She goes, atrocious and gauche, you know. She just totally hauls out the Brooklyn Jew right at that one tiny, tiny moment in the second verse. Okay, here we go. It's so subtle.
It's not cricket to picket, not cricket. Atrocious and gauche, you know, to picket.
Wait, I'm obsessed with that because it's almost like she's not even quite singing anymore. Okay, hold on. Just love it. One more time, one more time. And also, gauche. She sort of adds amazing vibrato to it, too. Here we go. I'm obsessed. I am.
It's not cricket to picket, not cricket. Atrocious and gauche, you know, to picket. Go home and starve like gentlemen, not like a noisy brood. Real ladies never make a fuss, though they lack clothes and food. And money's never talked about, for that would be quite rude. Not cricket to picket, not cricket.
Okay, so the third verse, she begins to have a full breakdown. Not as full as the fourth verse, but she now reverses words. It's not picket to cricket, because she's going slightly cuckoo. Then also she goes, my favorite placement, she goes, uncultured and unmannerly. She just does such an amazing in the mask placement of mannerly. It's focused with vibrato, obsessed. And then she hauls out her signature throatiness. She always hauls out throatiness. And she hauls it out when she has her sort of going to a grand mal breakdown. And on the very, very end, which is unrefined, full throaty. I've been smoking a pack a day. Okay, here we go. Reverses lyrics.
It's not picket to cricket, not picket. Uncultured and unmannerly to picket.
Great placement.
You know though you're misbehaving now, you mustn't lose your mind. You're being so inelegant and frankly quite unkind. Excuse my indiscretion, but you're all darned unrefined. Not picket to cricket, not picket.
You know, okay, so then finally the fourth verse, she has her full breakdown, and like literally none of the lyrics make sense. It's just like, it's all these icket rhymes, which I'm totally obsessed with. And then also I love, by the way, they add a full piano now and they add drums, and the tempo has really moved along. And then she's just full at the very end. She's quote unquote arrested, and I would like literally press the headphones against my ear at the end because she does this whole sort of monologue, which is obviously improvising, and it gets softer and softer, but I sort of was obsessed and essentially memorized it, but I'm obsessed with her arrested Jew from Brooklyn feigning she's British. Okay. Such a great performance at the very end. Here we go.
It ain't ticket to stick it, not picket. Now, officer, give each man there a cricket. Oh, dear, where is your decency? No Vanderbilts or Astors would ask in such a vulgar way, befitting only dastards. I beg you, get the hell away, you lousy buncher. What do you mean, disturbing the peace? Officer, you're bruising my bank. Get your hands off, kid. You don't seem to know who I am or whom I know. Listen, I'm an intimate friend.
Okay. Yeah, so soft. But wait, hold on. I just obsessed with it. I'm an intimate friend of, like, Jimmy Walker. She sort of says,
officer, you're bruising my bank. Get your hands off, kid. You don't seem to know who I am or whom I know. Listen, I'm an intimate friend of Jimmy Walker.
Anybody? Nobody. Peace out. Brava. Still got it.